हेलो एवरीवन, क्लास 11, बोर्स मॉडल ऑफ एटम। इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस बोर्स मॉडल ऑफ एटम। इन नील बोर डेवलप अ स्ट्रक्चरल मॉडल फॉर द हाइड्रोजन एटम। द मेन पोस्टुलेट्स आर, फर्स्ट, इन एन एटम the electron revolve around the nucleus in a certain definite circular path called orbits. So this is the nucleus around which these are the circular path which are present. These circular path are known as orbits. Okay, second postulate is each orbit is associated with definite energy. These are known as energy levels or energy shell. These are number as 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. or K, L, M, N, etc. This is the nucleus and this is the first energy shell, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So these are the six energy shell. First energy level is also named as K, second is named as L, third is named as M, fourth is named as N. Okay, so only those energy orbits are permitted for the electron in which the angular momentum of electron is a whole number multiple of h upon 2 pi. Thus the angular momentum of electron is mvr is equal to nh upon 2 pi. In this photograph, we are able to see this is the nucleus and these are the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth energy level. For energy level 1, we take n is equal to 1 value. Okay, in angular momentum formula, m is mass, v is velocity, r is radius of atom, n is number of energy level or shell, h is Planck's constant, and this is the value of pi. Okay, we substitute the value of n in this formula, we get m v r is equal to 1 h upon 2 pi, or m v r is equal to h upon 2 pi. So this is the angular momentum for first energy level. If we take n value 2, this is for energy level 2, the value comes to be m v r is equal to 2 h upon 2 pi cross 2 to 2. Okay, so value become m v r is equal to h upon pi. So this is the angular momentum of second energy level. Okay, now we will move to the next postulate. As long as electron present in a particular orbit, it neither absorbs or loses energy. This is considered as a stationary state or ground state of that particular electron in that particular atom. Okay, so if any energy is absorbed from any external source, this electron is jumped from its ground state to excited state. So this is the excited state. This excited state is a temporary state. Okay, so after some interval of time, it loses energy and return back to its ground state. Okay, the energy release in the form of radiation, that radiation is electromagnetic radiation. So the concept of ground state and excited state is given by Niels Bohr. Okay, we can understand the concept of ground state and excited state by this animation in which this electron is present at its ground state. When it gain energy from any external source, then it reaches to the excited state. You can see this image carefully. Okay, it absorbs energy and reaches to the excited state, and it is loses the energy and comes to the ground state again. Okay, whenever a electron loses energy from its excited state and reaches to its ground state, it releases energy in the form of radiation. This radiation is known as electromagnetic radiation. So in this photograph, you can see this is the excited state and this is the ground state. So electron jump from its excited state to the ground state and releases energy in the form of radiation. That radiation is known as electromagnetic radiation. Okay. Now we will discuss the achievement of Bohr's model of atom. First is stability of an atom. Bohr gave the concept of ground state and excited state. Okay. On the basis of ground state and excited state, he is able to explain the stability of the atom. He says, when electron is present at its ground state, it never loses the energy or gain the energy. Okay, never loses or gain the energy. Okay, if it absorbs energy from any external source, it jumps from its ground state to excited state. Okay, so this is the excited state. This excited state is temporary state. After some interval of time, the electron will reaches to its ground state again, and it releases energy in the form of radiation. That radiation is known as electromagnetic radiation. So this is the explanation given by the Bohr for the stability of atom. Okay, now he also calculated the energy of an electron in each energy level. Okay, so there E is energy in term of minus 21.8 into 10 to the power minus 12 Z square upon N square ergs per atom. Okay, here Z is atomic number and N is number of orbit or number of energy level or shell. Okay, so if we convert this erg into joule per atom, the value will become minus 21.8 into 10 to the power minus 19. Okay, here energy in terms of electron volt, the value is minus 13.6 into Z square upon N square. Here Z is atomic number and N is number of orbit or energy level. Okay, similarly, if we want to calculate energy in term of kilojoule per mole, the formula is E is equal to minus 1312 N square Z square. Okay, here Z is atomic number and N is number of orbit or energy level. Okay, now calculation of Bohr's radius. So this is the formula. In this formula, this N is, this Z is atomic number, this N is number of orbits or energy level. Here H is Planck's constant, this is pi, this is mass of electron, and this is charge on electron. When we calculate this whole part, the value comes to be 0.529 N square upon Z angstrom. Here Z is atomic number n is number of orbit or energy level. Okay, so calculation of velocity of an electron, velocity of the electron in different orbits will be calculated Vn 2.188 × 10^6 z upon n meter per square. Here n is number of orbit and z is atomic number. Okay, so these are the formula by which we can calculate the energy, radius and velocity of the electron. Okay, now limitation of Bohr's theory. The first limitation is the theory could not explain the atomic spectra of the atom containing more than one electron. As we discuss in this video, that Bohr is able to identify the structure of atom for hydrogen, that is only for one electron system. Okay, so he is not able to explain the atomic spectra of more than one electron. Okay, so not able to give the satisfactory explanation for Zeeman effect and Stark effect. What is Zeeman effect? When a spectral line is passed through the magnetic field, it split into multiple lines. This is known as Zeeman effect. He is not able to explain this effect. Okay, similarly Stark effect. When a single line is passed through electric field, it split into multiple lines. Is not able to explain the Stark effect. Okay. Third, it is not able to explain the shape of the molecule formed by the combination of the atom. So Bohr is not able to explain the shape of the molecule formed by the combination of atoms. Okay. The serious drawback comes from the new principles such as de Broglie's relationship and Heisenberg uncertainty principle. When these principles are discovered, there are so many drawbacks are observed in the Bohr's atomic model. These topics we will discuss in next video. Hope you are able to understand this topic. Thank you. I'm not.